So I wanted to talk about Paddington 2 again, and I wanted to talk about why the film resonated so much with me. You know, the movie really hit me, and I want to talk about why it's an amazing movie. This is not my second review for Paddington. I don't want you to think that it is, but I'm sure many people will think that that's what I'm doing here, but it's really not. I wanted to talk more about Paddington 2, because here's the thing, all right? Let me explain. You know, I usually don't go see kids' movies, and the reasons why I don't go see kids' movies is because I've been burned too many times on what Hollywood portrays kid movies to be like. You know, I feel like a lot of times, not just Hollywood, but also just the Western, just Western culture in general, I feel like they dumb themselves down and they really make themselves really pander to kids. And you know, when you look at the trailers for the first Paddington movie, you could definitely get that fear. But when you actually watch the movie, you find a movie that respects children and understands that kids are not dumb. And I really hate how movies always try to do something to purposely appeal to the kids. And it just comes off like pandering and just stupid nonsense that to me is insulting and I wouldn't even take a kid to go see it. Or sometimes they come off too preachy. But with Paddington, what I loved about the movie is that it was definitely a kid's movie. The humor is mostly slapstick and cartoony, but it's not insulting or disrespectful to its audience. And that's what I think really stood out to me about this movie. And I also feel like Paul King really paid respect to the source material. You know, I read Paddington when I was very little, and I mean like very little. And I actually believe that Paddington... And this is another reason why the movie resonates with me. This is going to be a very personal video. I was an immigrant, just like Paddington. I'm not of this country, and I didn't even learn to speak English until I got to elementary school. I spoke Spanish. That was my primary language. And seeing this story of what is essentially a Peruvian bear, he's from Peru, which means he's Hispanic, and well, not Hispanic, but Spanish of Spanish heritage, like me, coming to London, you know, and they don't really explore that. You know, he doesn't really speak Spanish in the movie, but still, you can relate to when you're an immigrant and you're coming to a place you've never been to before and how scary it can be. You know, and I remember coming to school as a little boy when I was 5 and just being scared because I didn't really know any English, and I was surrounded by all these kids who I thought were smarter than me because they spoke English, but the reality was it was just that was their native language and Spanish was mine. But I think that, you know, and it's hard for me to remember, but I'm pretty sure I read a lot of Paddington when I was a kid during this time. Paddington, in a funny way, because the story's about an immigrant, kind of helped me sort of learn English by reading the Paddington books, and I definitely remember the Paddington. And I talked about this in my actual movie review. I actually remember vividly the Paddington TV show, the one from the 70s that had the stop-motion puppet combination, you know, which really was is a very charming show, but I feel like a lot of my younger friends would not, they wouldn't get it. Like, it's so old school and so simple, and, you know, it only has one or two bits per episode, and it's just not what people are watching nowadays on Cartoon Network. It's not even close. You know, I feel like they wouldn't get it. But if you watch that show or if you watch that, you know what I'm talking about. It was almost just so refreshing to watch just how they portrayed this puppet of Paddington, you know, with the way he looks around. He's always confused, but he's always confused but calm in a good way. You know, and I've talked about how Paddington's the kind of person who I want to be like. I strive to be like him because he's extremely patient. And he has a lot of very high morals. And so when I watched the film, you know, there's a reason why this is the best reviewed movie of all time. It's getting 5 stars everywhere. There's a reason for this. It's not an accident. It really is a genuinely incredible film. And I, you know, when watching it, you know, again, I don't watch kids' movies. And I was so worried that Paddington was going to rap and be on a smartphone. And you know the crap that you see with these kids' movies, you know, like the emoji movie, all this nonsense. You know, I thought he was going to turn to this hip-hop bear, but, you know, Paul King really, really paid homage to the, you know, source material, including the bit with the barbershop, you know, in the movie, which is there was a very similar, not identical, but a very similar episode of the Paddington TV show with the barbershop, you know, and Paddington messing that up, you know. And, you know, the thing about Paddington, dude, is that, you know, we often see stories in kids' movies of, like, you know, fish out of water, you know, the bear, the animal, you know, they go to the house and they end up, you know, flooding the house and all that stuff. You know, Paddington started all that. Like, that was Paddington, dude, in the old, decades ago, Paddington started that whole gimmick of, you know, being naive and making mistakes, but eventually forgiving the other person, which so many situation comedies, so many sitcoms stole that from Paddington. Like, Paddington's, people don't understand just how influential Paddington was and is. So watching this movie in the movie theater, I was so happy watching it. You know, I mean, and that, here's the thing. I was actually kind of sick going in there. I had a little bit of nausea. I didn't feel too good. But I just went through it and just really just enjoyed it. And there were people talking about how they cried during this movie. Now, I didn't cry. But if you did cry, you know, I definitely can feel you on that, because the movie really hits you. You know, the themes of family and the themes of, especially the ending. The ending is so touching, you know, and I'm so happy they're making another Paddington movie. But I wanted to talk a little bit more about why it hit me, because, like, it was so the antithesis of what I was worried about. It's the kind of movie that I would love to take my kids to. I don't have any kids right now, but if I do have some, I would love to take my kids to go see this movie, because it's not, you know, I've got the first one on Blu-ray, and I'm definitely going to buy the second one when it comes out. It's just a movie that respects you. Like, there's a couple things that are a little unrealistic, but nothing to where you're just totally, like, taken out of it. You know what I mean? Like, the movie respects its audience and of all ages. And it's crazy because they were able to emote Paddington so well in the old, you know, stop motion puppet show. And in this movie with CGI, like, this was crazy. This is like light years ahead of Jar Jar Binks here. You know, the CGI in this movie looked incredible, and it didn't even have that big of a budget. Like, there's scenes where Paddington's, like, crying or getting teary or, you know, worried or happy, and you can just see it. You know, you just see it. Like, you see, it feels real. Like, this CGI bear feels real. And even the actor said so. You know, and it really hit me, you know. And after seeing so many nihilistic movies and movies that are just dreary, you know, seeing this movie that gives hope to humanity and gives hope that, you know, we don't have to be snakes. We don't have to be dicks. We can be better than that. We can turn people who are bad better. We can achieve better things and think about each other. It's something that people need to see. I really feel that way. This and Shape of Water, because I feel like Shape of Water is very similar in that the movie really hammers home sort of the idea of fitting in and how in the world sometimes you don't know what your place is and you don't know what your path is. And I'll be honest with you, you know, I don't talk about this too much, but I don't know what my path is. You know, I've been able to build a successful channel over on Geekdom 101, and I am trying to build this channel up too. It's going to be a lot harder, and I'm not afraid to work for it, but it's also one of those things where I don't really know what my end goal is in life right now. I really don't know what I want to accomplish. I'm just kind of working and trying to save up money and eventually maybe buy a house someday, you know, or finance a house. I can't buy a house cash. I wish. I want to do that, you know, and that would be cool. You know, I wouldn't have to worry about paying rent anymore and just kind of live peacefully. I'm kind of a simple guy. I don't really ask for much in life. And the movie had such an impact on me that I've gone back to watch those old skits, those old Paddington TV show skits, which are on YouTube, by the way, and they're so simple that they're so made for kids, but me being a grown man watching them, it gives me this weird feeling. And it's not nostalgia. It is not nostalgia. That's not what it is, but it's a weird feeling. It's a weird sort of comforting feeling that makes me realize that, you know, there's hope in the world, but also makes me dreary because you don't ever see it, you know, and I feel like people have to really remember that, you know. I think that we focus so much on the negative so often, dude. And sometimes you got to stop focusing on the negative and just think about the positive and think about what you can bring to the world and that we're all here to help each other. See, if you look at it like that, like we're all here to genuinely help each other, then we will help each other. You help me, I help you. But then, you know, things get selfish and we want attention. And, you know, I'm guilty of it as much as anybody else is. I consider myself a very selfish person sometimes, which is something that I'm dealing with right now on a personal level. You know, this is a very personal video right here. I'm just talking. I'm literally just talking to y'all. But, you know, it's just a movie that I think, and again, maybe I'm an idiot for not seeing other films like this, but seeing Shape of Water and then this movie back to back really kind of resonated with me, like I said. And, you know, I want everybody out there to go see the movie. I know that this is not a review, I swear, but you got to check out Paddington 1 and then Paddington 2, because it really, you know, check out, you got to see the first one, because you can see kind of the groundwork being laid for the second movie. But the second movie is better, and just what a great time it was. And I've been thinking about this movie, and it's so rare that I actually leave a movie theater thinking about a movie like this. Like, that's such a simple kids movie, but it just resonated with me. And maybe it has something to do with, you know, what I'm going through mentally right now. I've been through a lot of weird emotional trauma for the past year, which I don't talk about publicly, but there's been a lot of stuff going on in my life, you know, and it's one of those things where maybe this movie came at the right time, you know, for me. But man, maybe you won't like it as much as I do, but I'm so happy it's getting so much love from so many different places, and I hope it continues to get love, and I hope that, because there's other things too. I mean, I already went into in the review about how beautiful the cinematography is and the directing and the animation, that the editing is brilliant. But, like, you know, it's one of those movies that just, I really hope it really, more people go see this movie and it becomes a classic. It needs to become a classic. Like, this needs to become a film classic. And I really feel strongly about it. So that's what I have for you today. I know it's random, but I wanted to get that off my chest and really talk to y'all. So Movie Ramblings is the playlist. So thank you, and I'll see you soon.